Says it's for emotional support, but the city says it's not allowed.
Tonight, a Festus family says they're being forced to get rid of their pet pig despite a doctor's recommendation. Thank you for joining us. I'm Steve Savard.
I'm Courtney Bryant. News 4's Emma Hogue is finding out if that owner has any legal chance at keeping her pig. Emma?
Courtney, Steve, it's a battle that's gone on for months. This woman says she needs the pig for health reasons, but tonight the city says they're not changing this ordinance.
Comforting knowing that you have that companionship.
For most, pets are an important part of any family.
My pets are like my children.
Debbie Buff and her son Aiden have quite the lineup.
Two cats, mouse and fatty cat, and we have a bearded dragon.
But their latest addition is a whopping 100 pounds with a twirly tail and snout. Yes, a mini pig named Pickles they've had for over a year.
He loves treats.
But soon,
devastation,
might have to live without.
Heartbreak.
Tonight, the city of Festus says the pig must be gone by October 17th. The ordinance bans livestock within city limits and comes with a $250 fine each day.
Animals classified as livestock, in this case a pig or mini pig, cannot be kept as pets.
City Administrator Greg Camp says council spent months considering amending the violation, but after weighing input from citizens, it stands as is.
Someone would perhaps rightfully or wrongfully take advantage of that new opening in the ordinance.
Buff's doctor signed this letter saying she should be allowed to keep her pet pig for emotional support.
It's been a hard year, but she's made it better.
Her son is on the autism spectrum, and Buff now battles depression and anxiety after losing her oldest son last year.
She brings a sense of like peace and comfort to me when I need it.
Tonight, Buff fears 3 weeks is all they have left.
It's going to turn our whole world upside down again.
Says Festus city leaders are well within their legal bounds, but tonight, Buff says she'll continue to fight this. In studio, Emma Hogue, News 4.